If you turn away from the Quran, you have got a life of difficulty. Yes. We leave the Quran, we leave the Sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, there is nothing but misery for us in this world. Yeah. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَامًا. Abdullah Abdul Rahman, you can see me and I can see you today. But on the day of Qiyamah, if we turned away from the teachings of the Qur'an, if we turned away from the Qur'an and Sunnah, Allah protect us, Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. What will happen? فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً دَنْكَ وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَامًا. Allah says, we will resurrect these kind of people who turn away from my Qur'an in the state of blindness, Allahu Akbar. Allah save us, Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. We will face all kinds of issues. In our wealth, in our wealth, in our health, in our life, if we leave the teachings of the Quran. Man a'rada an dhikri, Allah says, whosoever will turn away from my remembrance, meaning what? Al Quran. Fa inna lahu ma'ishatan dhanka. For this person, there will be a life of hardship, Allahu Akbar. Don't we know the stories of the Anbiya alayhi salam? They were the ones that were tested the most, yet they never turned away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A little bit of difficulty comes me and you, straight away, what have I done wrong? What have I done wrong? I prayed my 5 prayers, I give charity, I do this, I do that. And why has Allah just picked on me? La hawla wa la quwwata. You had the ayats coming to you. The reminders came to you. The ayats of Allah were recited to you. The Quran of Allah was recited to you. The ahadith of my Nabi, Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, were mentioned to you. Yet you chose to turn away from them. Kadhalik atatka ayatuna fanasitaha. You forgot them. You put them behind your back. Said, today we're going to forget you, Allahu Akbar. Allahumma ihfazna min amin ya rabbal alamin. Allah protect us, Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. Brothers and sisters, this relationship with the Quran that me and you should have is not a mere relationship of valuing the Quran, putting it on the top shelf, putting it in a beautiful cloth, in a juzdan, yeah? And getting the nice case and putting it on top. The more we value something, the more our relationship will be stronger with that thing. The more we turn away from it, and the more less value we give, the more we will go away from the Quran. Allah. Nowadays, subhanallah, everybody wants to pray Taraweeh. Where is the fastest? Subhanallah. Hafiz Saab prays in 40 minutes. But the mosque down the road, he prays in 35 minutes. Yeah? 5 minutes difference, man. Yeah. So I'm going to go to that mosque. Why? Because he's praying faster. What haqq are we giving to the Quran? Subhanallah. Is this our relationship? That this month of Quran, the month in Ramadan, where Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do recitation with Jibreel Amin alayhi salam. Your daddy, they used to pray to each other. He used to pray to Jibreel. He used to listen to Jibreel. The month of Quran, of Ramadan, and this month, the value we show that we don't want to listen to the Taraweeh with its proper recitation. We'd prefer to listen to it in fast mode. Allahu Akbar. Do we feel this as a burden? Then there is a problem in our hearts. If we don't feel it as a burden to listen to the Quran with love and zeal, and to stand there like Maulana mentioned, Allahu Akbar, in one rak'ah, Uthman ibn Affan, Zubair ibn al-Awwam, Tamim Adari radiyallahu ta'ala anhum majma'in, Imam Hanifa rahimahullah, one rak'ah, the holy Quran, the whole of the Quran, subhanallah. Can me and you stand for that long? Allahu Akbar. We start to call the Imam crazy. La hawla wa la quwwata. Was it, this guy's crazy, man? He doesn't know how to recite, subhanAllah. Eh? The guy's taking so long, man. Does he know what he's doing? We'll come out with ahadith. Oh, make sure you consider about the elderly and the young and the women. And we'll come out with our arguments here and there, left, right and center. And nowadays, la hawla wa la quwwata, fitna is increasing day by day. We don't even have the time. I'm not going to go down the route of arguing regarding the 20 rak'ah of Taraweeh Sunnah Mu'akkad. I'm not going to go down that route. I'm going to say clear here. The fitna is, we don't have time to listen to the Quran. We are deprived. This 1 month, that we have when we have the opportunity of listening to the Quran in Salatul Taraweeh from Alif Lam Mim to Wan Nas, and we don't even have the opportunity and we don't even have the decency to stay for Taraweeh for that 1 month so that we can listen to the whole of the Quran. You tell me, have we ever taken time out that we listen to the Quran from Alif Lam Mim to Wan Nas at the other time of the years? Very difficult. This one opportunity that we get, and then we want to come out with fatwas from our batwas here. Pocket fatwa here. Yeah. The Taraweeh is still continuing in the masjid. You have time to chit-chat outside. Yeah. You have time to go to the coffee shop. And I know, and I'm speaking to brothers who know this is happening in the communities. I'm not going to fight. You can invite me again, Mawlana, I'm not bothered. If you don't want to invite me, I'll say haqwal, I don't feel shy. You got to listen what has to be listened. We don't want to listen to the Quran. We want to go to the coffee shop. We want to chit-chat. The Taraweeh is taking place. We'll be in the passage out there, chit-chatting. Is this the value we give to the Quran? Is this our relationship with the Quran? That the only month which is called the month of Quran, this is the respect we show. How do you think Allah is going to deal with me and you then? Allahu Akbar. Is this the value we give to the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When they read the Quran, everything was there under their control. But we have left the Quran. We have left the teachings of Quran. We have left the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And today we face nothing but humiliation and humiliation and humiliation. Learn the Quran. Teach the Quran. And this should be your daily routine. And if this is the way you have your relationship with the Quran, وَلَا تَزَالُ كَذَلِكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْمَوْتِ. And this should be your condition until death comes onto you. Until death comes onto you. فَإِنْ أَتَاكَ الْمَوْتُ وَأَنْتَ كَذَلِكَ. And if this is your condition, that you are learning the Quran, you are teaching the Quran, you are learning the Quran, you are teaching the Quran, you are practicing the Quran, you are implementing the Quran, you are understanding the Quran, this is your condition, then Allahu Akbar. Look at your value, Abdullah. Look at your value, Abdul Rahman. Look at your value, O Zainab. Look at your value, O Fatima. Allah's Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Zaratil malaikatu qabrak kama yuzarul baytul atiq," or kama qala alayhi salatu wa taslim, the angels will visit our grave. Subhanallah, subhanallah. Say la ilaha illallah. The angels will visit your grave like we visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Makkah al-Mukarramah, Baytullah al-Haram. The angels will come and visit our graves. وَإِنَّ هَذِهِ الْقُلُوبُ تَصْدَى. These hearts, Nabi Pak Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, these hearts, they get rusted. They get rusted. إِنَّ هَذِهِ الْقُلُوبُ تَصْدَى كَمَا يَسْتَهُ الْحَدِيدُ إِذَا أَصَابَهُ الْمَاءُ. Like they get rusted. Like iron gets rusted when water touches it. When water touches it, the iron is going to get rusted. The Sahaba straight away, they said to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَمَا جِلَأُهَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Oh Habib, if our hearts are going to get rusted, if rust is going to come onto our hearts, then how, what is the way? What is the prescription of trying to eradicate that, trying to take that away and cleansing it? وَمَا جِلَأُهَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, with the remembrance of Allah and the tilawat of the Quran. Subhanallah. The tilawat of the Quran. Love for me. Do we need the love of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? Yes or no? Yes or no? Do we need the love of Allah? Yes or no? Do we need the love of Rasulullah, yes or no? Or do we only need the love of our wives, huh? And our husbands. Is that only we say, oh, I love you, honey, honey, yeah? It's all we say. We should have the love of Allah and the love of Rasulullah. That love should be above all love. All part of our life. We've been sent to this world as examination. If we pass our examination, we will get our certificate. Will enter into Jannah, inshallah. Yeah? And on that day, ala ru'usil khalaiq, in front of the whole of mankind, Allah will honor us, inshallah. Say inshallah, yeah? Allah will honor us, inshallah. He will grant us Jannah, inshallah. And we hope He grants us Jannah without reckoning, inshallah. Yeah? Without reckoning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant.